Hello, Forrest. How are you doing?
Don't come any closer.
No, I'm not. I'm going to put this right like that. Is that okay?
Are you rolling?
I'm sorry?
Are you rolling?
I am rolling. Do you have anything you want to say to everybody?
Hello, everybody.
Okay. How are you doing?
Okay.
Very good. I love your hat.
This is my hat.
Okay, I want to pay you. Stay there a second, okay? Just a minute. Okay.
What is that?
I am going to pay you in toilet paper, and I don't want to get more, I don't want to get close to you.
Throw it out here.
So, how about if I go like this? Are we 6 feet?
Thank you.
And I have... A number of years ago, before this quote came out, I wondered if the poem started in Forrest Fenn's driveway. The poem starts as I have gone alone in there. Is I Forrest? Is he giving us a direction right from his driveway? Does have gone mean have gone, as in go northeast? To me at the time, it meant go northeast on the Santa Fe Trail. Forrest even wrote a chapter in his Too Far to Walk book talking about the Santa Fe Trail going right through his yard. The Santa Fe Trail sign symbol is a wagon wheel. The wagon wheel symbol reminded me of Cal Laser's vlog back in 2017, where he solved the poem to say, try the wheel. So leaving Forrest's house, we can go northeast on the Santa Fe Trail and get up to Cimarron Canyon and Touch Me Not Mountain. As I entered Las Vegas, I remembered Forrest refined his quote in 2017 that the treasure is hidden more than 8.25 miles north of the northern limit of Santa Fe, New Mexico. This meant I needed the latitude of the northern limit of Santa Fe, as well as the latitude on a certain reference point going up the Santa Fe Trail. I looked up the latitude of Montezuma Hot Springs, a potential warm waters haul, but it was south of Santa Fe. To complete the directional hint in the first line, as I have gone alone in there, does the word alone allude to Hermit Peak? I needed the latitude of Hermit Peak. The latitude of Hermit Peak is indeed north of the northern limit of Santa Fe, so I felt that anything north of Hermit Peak meets the criteria and is a valid search area. As I passed Story Lake, which was deserted due to the pandemic, I knew it was only a few more miles until I'd be able to see Hermit Peak off to the west. As I made my way north past the highlands to the east and higher into the trees, I decided to leave the Santa Fe Trail at Buena Vista and continue north to La Cueva and Mora, the small town with the pink houses. Every time I drive down Main Street in Mora, I think of John Mellencamp's song Pink Houses from 1983. This is where I left 518 and continued north on Highway 434 up towards Guadalupita and Coyote Creek State Park. Soon after crossing the Mora River, you pass the remains of the St. Vrain's Grist Mill. This area is sitting at around 7,200 feet, and if I would have continued north on 518, I would have soon come into the little town of Cleveland. You know, you football fans, the Cleveland home of the Browns. Unfortunately, the Victory Ranch has closed after 28 years of raising alpacas. I visited this place a number of years ago, and it was incredible. They had hundreds, if not thousands, of alpacas that you could feed. I continued north on 434 through the little village of Guadalupita, climbing an elevation as I was reaching Coyote Creek State Park. Even though I never had a solve for Coyote Creek State Park, it was always one of the stops for my dogs and myself as we went out searching for Fenn's treasure. The drive up through Guadalupita Canyon along Coyote Creek has always been one of my favorite drives, even if I'm not treasure hunting. In my opinion, one of the most beautiful sights in New Mexico is when you crest this plateau and you see the mountains around Taos for the first time. The ranch land on the west side of the highway is where they shot the 1989 miniseries, Lonesome Dove. The mountain range in the distance is part of the Sangre de Cristo mountain range. That translates to Blood of Christ. You know, all you Forrest Fenn treasure hunters, Forrest said, "My church is in the mountains." That's why a lot of us really liked searching in New Mexico, at least in the early years. I have now entered the little town of Angel Fire. It sits around 8,400 feet in elevation and is on the edge of the Enchanted Circle. This is where Road 434 ends, and I actually joined the Enchanted Circle. I will now make my way from Angel Fire to Eagle Nest. The Eagle Nest area and the Cimarron Canyon were probably the first most popular places to search for Forrest Fenn's treasure in the early years. Forrest dropped a bomb on this area in May 2014 when he said, "I will say now that WWH is not related to anything." For the savvy Forrest Fenn treasure hunter, that did not matter. I'm not going to give this away though, because this is still an active search area for many searchers. So if you want to understand what I'm talking about, you need to Google Eagle Nest and go to the Wikipedia page, then you will understand. From here, I continued past the Eagle Nest Lake Dam and climbed up over the hills here and then dropped down into Cimarron Canyon. This is a very popular place for the Homa Brown, I believe it was, because of the special trout waters that are along the Cimarron River here down through the canyon. I never had a really good salt for all nine clues here, although I have been there looking around, and I had hiked there previous years, not looking for Fenn's treasure. Here I'm passing the Clear Creek Trailhead, where I took 10-year-old Thomas's mom's and the Golden Retrievers to make his segment of my movie for Sundance back in 2015. And just so you all know, my movie was not accepted into the Sundance Film Festival. This half-mile stretch through Cimarron Canyon is what makes this trip worthwhile to me. It's called the Palisades. You can see on the other side of the plaque the points of interest And if you look on the right side of it, that dotted line is the Santa Fe Trail. Up ahead is the turn off to the Maverick Campground, and soon after that, the trail to the Maverick Falls, another popular search area. And I just love it when the wildlife cooperate with me and posture themselves like they are paid extras in my movie. From here, I made my way through the rest of Cimarron Canyon, Ute Park, and down into the town of Cimarron, where the plains meet the Rocky Mountains. Here I turned east on Route 21, and I'm once again back on the Santa Fe Trail. In my opinion, the best thing about the town of Cimarron is the St. James Hotel. Wikipedia says, it is known for its legendary status of being haunted by the spirits of men murdered there in the 19th century during northeastern New Mexico's Wild West days. I actually had the pleasure of staying there a few years ago. Unfortunately, we did not see any ghosts that were positive were ghosts, but we did enjoy the margaritas at the outside bar. Not far after leaving Cimarron, I entered the Philmont Boy Scout Ranch. I asked Forrest in an email if he knew Wade Phillips, the brother who's credited with donating this land to the Boy Scouts. This was his reply. I knew Shope, Waite, and Philip R. Phillips, who was a major antique gun collector. I really liked all of them, and their father was a close friend of Joseph Sharp, whose biography I wrote twice. Is there a Joseph Sharp connection to this area? The ranch covers over 140,000 acres of wilderness in the Sangre de Cristo Mountains. Unfortunately, in the summer of 2018, 27,000 acres of Philmont were damaged in the Ute Park fire. One of the good parts about this area is the historic adobe B&B called Casa del Gavilan, which means hawk in Spanish. It used to be that if you stayed there, you had access to some of the hiking trails, but I think that's been discontinued in the last few years. It's really unfortunate that only Boy Scouts can come here and hike the trails here. I always wanted to go up on Yuraca Mesa, where there's been stories about lost scouts, compasses that don't work, and tales of eerie blue lights. Yuraca means magpie in Spanish, part of the crow family. They are traditionally associated with deception and are seen as the messengers of death. Hence the eerie blue lights outside the portal to the underworld. You might be wondering, what does this have to do with Forrest's poem? Well, even since the early days, people thought the north part of the mesa looked like a skull. An eye in the skull was said to be the door to the underworld. Is this what Forrest meant when he said, from there it's no place for the meek? I've had searchers confess to me that they have actually trespassed and they have hiked and they've searched for Forrest's treasure on the Philmont Scout Ranch property. I've always wanted to do this, but I'm afraid that magpies are going to come and get me. If you're ever in this area, I highly recommend visiting the National Scouting Museum. One of the last things I want to mention before leaving the Philmont Scout Ranch is this prominent geographic feature called the Tooth of Time. And speaking of time, it's time to wrap up this video. I hope you enjoyed my tour of the Santa Fe Trail, Angel Fire, Eagle Nest, Cimarron Canyon, and the Philmont Scout Ranch. I want to end my video the way Forrest has ended his books, with a colophon of double omegas. This is the Express UU Bar Ranch, and a favorite for Forrest Fenn searchers looking for a double omega. I have one more thing I want to say. The next time you hide a treasure chest, forget the gold. Fill it with toilet paper. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.